Hello, wrestling fans. The senior correspondent Rick Rocker here, alongside former No Mercy champion, ECW World Tag Team champion, and a whole lot of other champions. Stuart Winger is out here with me tonight for a very special edition of U Class Wrestling Academy. Something very special, ladies and gentlemen. On the foreground tonight. Winger, why don't you tell the audience what is going on around here?
Well, alright, Ben, so it's crunch time here for Tennessee Pro Wrestling, especially for the new class Wrestling Academy. It's been over 1 year already, fans, that the Academy has been established. And we're about to find out by the end of this day who will be going to the main roster, Tennessee Pro Wrestling Organization, No Mercy Hardcore Wrestling Organization, and of course, the Ladies Championship Wrestling Organization. And we're starting things off with a league challenge match in the heavyweight division. Raoul Duke and Dr. Gonzo, Fear and Loathing in Las Vegas. And Rick, this is going to be a very exciting match. Absolutely. Both men are best of friends, colleagues, practically brothers, head-to-head in this league challenge, but determine who will be going into the main roster to represent Fantasy Pro Wrestling. Raoul Duke right now has an opportunity. Should he win this match via submission, he will have earned more points than Dr. Gonzo. Matter of fact, here's how it works. For those of you who don't remember, those who win by submission will earn themselves 5 points in the leaderboard. But by pinfall, which is very common, mind you, you will be earning 3 points. Which means if Raoul Duke pins Dr. Gonzo to the mat, 1, 2, 3, yes, then you'll earn points in the league challenge and leaderboard, but for this land, he will not exactly outbeat Dr. Gonzo in terms of points. So, hopefully that wasn't too confusing, but it's all about numbers. The numbers game at this juncture of the state of the Academy and also Fantasy Pro Wrestling. And every year this happens, but the championship committee by the month of August has to make an evaluation of who is going to be leaving FPW, No Mercy, and Ladies Championship Wrestling, and states. And I think it's every manager's difficult job to do the cuts. Removing wrestlers away from what they love to do, that is to perform on a month-by-month basis. Raoul Duke now setting up possibly Dr. Gonzo for a finisher. Can't seem to do it. Can't seem to negotiate. This will not bode well. Hold the phones. Hold the phones. Super kick. Quickly done. But that is not going to suffice because of the ropes. The ropes can be your best friend or your worst enemy. Very true, very true. Cannot doubt that at all. Must say though, Rick, it's been a pleasure to call the action down the middle each and every chance that we can get. Unfortunately, we're not as consistent as other wrestling organizations because, well, let's face it, we have lives of our own. We don't make a living off of doing stuff like this, as opposed to Ring of Honor, AEW, WWE, etc., etc., etc. We don't make any money off of this. This is strictly out of love. Passion, if you will. Speaking of love and passion, Carolina Rodriguez is now interfering in this matchup. You're making this contest a little bit more interesting than it already is. here in our, oh my goodness. Carolina, what are you doing? What is your game plan, young woman? Raoul Duke now is, getting his momentum here. Oh, look at that beautiful swing and neck breaker there by Dr. Gonzo. Ah, cannot body slam him. Could not do it. And now in this 2-on-1 disadvantage. Oh, the falls! Look at that beautiful maneuver right there by Carolina Rodriguez! Seems to me that the tables have turned. It's gonna be something else if Dr. Gonzo wins this match, because if Dr. Gonzo wins this match, it will be indefinite. It will actually happen. Dr. Gonzo will be competing this fall, especially next month, when FCW Fantasy Pro Wrestling presents Homecoming. But until then, this coming Sunday, big pay-per-view of an extravaganza in alliteration. The only hardcore wrestling show of the year dedicated to all the old-time greats. There is one. Rob Van Dam, the Sandman, Dusty Rhodes, the late great Dusty Rhodes, that is. Shane Douglas, the first ever ECW World Champion. And look at this! Raoul Duke secures a victory over Gonzo by pinfall, as I mentioned. So now what is it? Now what happens? Well, we gotta go over the score system. When we come back after these commercial breaks, we're gonna come back and terrify what's gonna happen with his career, because now that Duke has won, it has changed the outcome significantly. Alright, well, that's a great matchup there by Raoul Duke. Jordan the victory, and that's all she wrote right there, ladies and gentlemen.